In Brown versus Board of Education, the famous case that desegregated schools in the 1950s, Dr. Kenneth Clark conducted adult tests with black children. He asked them to choose between a black doll and a white doll. In most instances, the majority of the children preferred the white doll. I decided to reconduct this test as Dr. Clark did to see how we've progressed since then.
Can you show me the doll that you like best or that you'd like to play with? Can you show me the doll that is the nice doll? And why is that the nice doll?
He's white.
And can you show me the doll that looks bad? Okay. And can you give, and why does that look bad?
Because it's black.
And why do you think that's a nice doll?
Because she's white.
And can you give me the doll that looks like you?
Fifteen out of the 21 children preferred the white doll.
Ready, set, go.
Our second major finding, even black children as a whole have some bias toward whiteness, but far less than white children.
She'll be the smart child. And why is she the smart child?
Because she is white.
Okay. Show me the dumb child. And why is she the dumb child?
Because she plays.
Well, show me the ugly child. And why is she the ugly child?
Because she plays.
Show me the good-looking child. And why is she the good-looking child?
Because she likes skinny.
And show me the skin color you believe most teachers think looks bad on a girl.
I don't think it matters. Because I think each teacher wants to help a student learn either way what they look like. And
yeah.
Like, it doesn't matter what you look like on the outside. It just matters what you look like on the inside.
Show me the good-looking child.
They look the same.
Yeah? Show me the child you would like as a classmate.
All of them.
You like all of them as classmates? Mm-hmm. Why do you say all of them?
Because I don't really care what color they have.
This 5-year-old girl gave some provocative answers during her test. I asked her about them later.
How about you? Why do you want that skin color?
Because it looks lighter than this kind, because this looks a lot like that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And I just don't like the way brown looks, because the way brown looks really nasty for some reason, but I don't know what reason. That's all.
So you think it looks nasty?
Well, not really, but sometimes.
Sometimes. And Brielle, they asked what color adults don't like. Do you remember what you said? Which one? That's right, that's what you said. Why do you think adults don't like that color?
Dark.
Dark. And adults, you think adults don't like dark?
Well, maybe some adults do, but maybe some of them don't.
Mm.
The questions that got overwhelmingly white-biased answers?
Show me the one you think most children would think looks bad on a boy.
More than 70% of the older black children chose the darkest skin tones.
Show me the child who has the skin color most children don't like.
More than 61% of the younger black children chose the two darkest shades.
Show me the ugly child.
More than 57% of the younger black kids chose the two darkest shades. Dr. Spencer says the research shows the bias toward white is still very much part of our culture.
All kids are exposed to these stereotypes, but what's really significant here is that white children are learning or maintaining those stereotypes much more strongly than the African American children.